Hi guys, Tom Morrison here, and I'm going to take you through one of the most important hip mobility tests ever. And before you think that this is some extreme advanced flexibility movement, it is not. This is advanced flexibility. We are going to show you what is needed for normal hip mobility. First of all, we're going to show you what the test is, and then we're going to go over why it is so important to be able to do this. Start off in a push-up position, and what you're going to do is bring one foot up beside the same side hand. Then, maintaining a vertical shin and without throwing your knee out to the side, what you're going to do is replace the palm of your hand with your elbow. This would be a pass on this side. Then, you're going to do the other side. The same idea, replace the palm of the hand with the elbow, and that'll be a pass on this side. If you can't get the elbow all the way down, make sure to take note on both sides where you're at. So if you're at different positions, make sure you take note of where you're at. So why is this test so important? The deep lunge test from the simplistic mobility method is designed to test your hip flexion. If you struggle to pass this test on one or both sides, you may experience back pain, hip pain, knee pain, reoccurring groin injuries, lack of muscle awareness, lack of muscle engagement, or just generally feeling stiff all of the time. So here are a few examples of what to look out for. Firstly, if you were to feel both sides, one common trait that you may notice is the butt wink. What happens is that you don't have the capacity to sit down into your hips properly to use the muscles in the right way, so the lower back has to compensate by rounding at the bottom of the squat. You'll get away with this for a while, maybe with body weight, but if you start to load this pattern up, you could be running the risk of injury, or at the start it'll just be general tightness. So if you're finding that you're getting a sore lower back a lot whenever training, this could be one of the reasons. Secondly, your knees could be being pulled inwards. This is one of those things that could already be happening and you may not notice the effects of it for years to come. So you want to be aware of it before these issues arise. Bones are heavily influenced by the muscles around them. You want to be able to stack everything into good alignment so that you're able to train properly and you're not going to be putting that stress on the joints over time. Finally, if your deep lunge was tighter on one side compared to the other side, this could present itself in wonky squats of going down sideways and coming back up, or just having constant lower back tightness on one side, or a tight glute on one side, or one hamstring that always plays up, or even one calf that always plays up. This could be the cause of that, and that's why you want to be able to pass the test equally on both sides. I am a big believer in having markers for your flexibility work. It's okay to say to someone to stretch every day, but what is the goal? You need to have something that you can actually achieve, and that's why the deep lunge test is a great thing to have. So if you're struggling to pass the test on one or both sides, you have that end game goal in mind of that's where you eventually want to get to. You don't want to rush it, but you know that there's something that you're going to achieve and you're going to benefit from at the end when you get it. So let's start improving your deep lunge. What you're going to do is use this same test to actually turn it into an exercise. So what Jenny's going to do is set up in the exact same way, bring the foot up and just go to wherever her elbow goes. So we'll make this as if you were struggling to actually pass the test. So if she's a wee bit further up, that's where you go to. She's then going to rotate up to the sky and then take a deep breath in here and then just breathe out as she comes back down, gradually trying to get the elbow down that little bit lower with each breath. And you want to repeat this for 5 to 10 reps or spend a few minutes on it on each side until you start to find a noticeable improvement. Even a couple of inches in the one session would be absolutely fantastic. For some of you, you may find the elbow gets right down very, very quickly. For others, it may take you a few weeks or even months, but you will eventually get there. I would say to do this daily and use it in every warm-up and make sure to do it on both sides, okay? So Jenny, swap side. And say this side here, she was significantly tighter on. She could add a few extra reps into this side to really start to see if she can get down lower into that position. And always be using that breath to bring yourself back down. Find an improvement with this over time. You will notice carrying over to your training and recovery very quickly. And you'd want to see that your squat depth will be improving and that your positions will be improving as well, so that you're actually getting something that you notice is transferring from the mobility work that you are doing, that is making what you do better, which is always a very important thing to have. If you look after your body, it will look after you. Let us know if you have any issues with your deep lunge, if it's tighter on one side or tighter on both sides. Can you pass the test? And or do you notice that you have that wonky squat, or maybe you get lower back pain whenever you're training? Let us know in the comments. And thank you very much for watching. If there's anything you'd like to see in the future, let us know, and please subscribe.